Good morning, students. Welcome you all in English class. Today I am going to teach you a new poem. Poem number 6, Mystery of the Talking Fan. This is written by Maud Ruby. It's a very small and funny poem. Just listen it carefully and understand. Before starting the poem, let's know about the poet. A small introduction of the poet I am sharing it with you. Maud Ruby was born on June 30, 1891. She died in October 1973 at 82 years of her age. Maud Ruby had been residing in Santa Ana, Orange City, California. Maud Ruby was a poetess with over 100 published poems and 42 state and national awards to her name. She has written more than 100 poems and she also received state and national awards. She is author of a book of poems titled Leaves of Laurels in 1968 and a contributor to Lyrics of Three Women in 1964. She was a great poetess. Let's start the poem. First of all, let's know about the central theme of the poem, what idea the poetess wants to share with you through this poem. So this poem opens with the personification of the fan. Personification where the non-living object was given the quality of the human, and being given human attributes such as the ability to talk and chatter. Here the poetess has given the ability of talk and chatter like a human being to the fan. The poet calls the fan's noise an electrical chatter. The poet is unable to know what exactly it means. She did not understand the mystery, and before she could solve this puzzle, somebody oiled the motor and the mystery was over. So let's begin this story. Stanza 1. There was only one stanza in the poem. Once there was a talking fan. Read with me, everybody. Once there was a talking fan, electrical his chatter. I could not quite hear what he said, and I hope it does not matter, because one day somebody oiled his little whirling motor and all the mystery was spoiled. He ran as still as water. What is the meaning of this line? First of all, in the first line the poet said there was a talking fan. So, talking fan. Okay, who talks like a human? And his chatter is electrical. Okay, you can read the explanation. The poet opens with the personification of the fan. Being given human attributes. Human quality is related, such as the ability to talk and chatter. The poet calls the fan's noise an electrical chatter. Okay, there was a fan in the room which was creating a noise, and this noise is electrical. So the poet calls it electrical chatter. The poet is unable to comprehend what exactly it means. It means the poet does not understand why this fan is making noise. It's a mystery. And before the poet could succeed in decoding the mystery, somebody oiled its motor. Before the poet came to know the fact about why this fan is making noise, somebody came and oiled the motor. Ever since, it functioned in such a smooth manner that no noise could be heard. Now after oiling, the motor was get oiled, and after that this whirling motor was running so smoothly, as smooth as water. And the talking fan fell silent and did not make more noise after this. So it was a summary, it was the explanation of the poem. I hope you understood. Let's read the summary of the poem. The poet is telling us about an electrical fan that made a lot of noise. The poet said he could not understand why there was so much noise or what the fan was trying to say. One day an electrician came and put oil in the noisy motor of the fan. After that, the movement of the fan became smooth and silent. The mystery of why the fan was talking got solved. So it's an interesting and funny poem. I hope it's very clear to you now. Let's know about the poetic device used in the poem. Poetic device is very important in writing the poems. The poet used this poetic device to give the beauty to their poems. Okay? And the poem Mystery of Talking Fan, the poet Modern Bean makes use of three poetic devices. Number one is personification. As I have already told you, personification of fan. Because the fan got the ability of talking and chattering like a human. Okay, so is personification is one of the figure of speech in which human emotions are attached with inanimate objects. In other words, natural and artificial objects are treated as persons, hence personification. And the second one is metaphor. Metaphor is what? Metaphor regarded as representative or symbolic of something. As in the first line of the poem, you can read, once there was a talking fan. Okay. So here, what is symbolic? A talking fan. So it's a metaphor. Understood? Next is simile. Simile is used for the comparison of one thing to another. Okay, so last line of the poem, you can see, he ran as still as water. As still as water. In simile, we use the word as or like. Did you understand? These three poetic devices were used in the poem. Next is rhyming scheme of the poem. What is the rhyming scheme of the poem, children? Listen it very carefully. Rhyming scheme is the similar sounding words we can take out the rhyming scheme of the poem through the last word of the poem. What is the last word of the first line? Fan. So you will write A. Okay. Second line last word is chatter. Is it sounding same like fan? No, it's different. So write B. Last word is sad in third line. Sad is similar to fan or chatter? No, so it is C. Next, fourth line last word is matter. It is same sounding like chatter. So you will write B. Clear? Next, oil. Oil is sounding like said. So it will be marked C. Motor. Chatter, matter, motor. Same sounding words. B. Spoiled. Like said and oil. So you will mark it C. Last line of the last word is water. Same like chatter, matter, motor. So you will mark B. So what is the rhyming scheme came out? A, B, C, B, C, B, C, B. I hope you all understood the poem. Students, read the poem once. And if you have any doubt, you can make message to me. Enjoy doing study at home. Take care.